Today we go over the takedown section of the dummy form. Hey, welcome to Practice Wing Chun, where we discuss Wing Chun and answer any training related questions. My name is Edgar, and this is episode 34 of Practice Wing Chun. So today is another class note episode, and what I worked on yesterday was the takedown portion of the dummy section. And coincidentally, Gary emailed asking more about takedowns. So before we get started, I just want to say that I have very little experience in takedowns, so yesterday was the most intensive class I've had on takedown in a very long time. So essentially, there's a section, I think it's section 7 of the Wing Chun Dummy form, where there's a point where you go like this, and then you take them down. Now, on the dummy, some of the steps are missing because when you try it on a live person, sometimes you won't have enough space or you're not stepping in close enough to your opponent to sweep them and take them down. And having the right placement, having the right arm placement also helps. So one thing my Sifu mentioned was whichever leg you're sweeping with, the same side arm should be above and the other arm should be lower. So if I'm sweeping with the right leg, I want my right arm higher, so when I sweep, I can bring them down. So I'm going to try to demonstrate this on the dummy. To demonstrate again the original form, you go like this, where you kind of gum cell the bottom arm, and you push your arm over while stepping in, and then you just kind of sweep them. But in a real life application, the person may not be this close. The person may actually be further back, further away. So you need to step in before. So that's what I went over yesterday. I kind of just went over the motions over and over again until my body got used to it. I used to stepping, to moving around, to making sure my hand placement was correct. And yeah, that was just mostly the focus. And I really like using the applications, the real life examples from the dummy form, because that way now I kind of understand why it's done. And for me, I think the dummy form is essentially the best way to kind of see Wing Chun in action, because you see all your movements, they're applied to the dummy, and when you learn the application for it, it just kind of opens your eyes to why the form is done a certain way, what each section of the dummy represents. In my school, the Wing Chun dummy has 8 sections. I don't know how I went like this. There's 8 sections. For section 7, focus more on defending and sweeping or taking down your opponent. So I really like it. I really enjoyed that section. I'm almost done with the form applications before I move on to something else. So next week, hopefully, I'll continue learning the next section or even reviewing more of the takedown stuff, because once again, I don't have much experience in it and I would like to further practice it. So going back to Gary's question about takedowns, he wanted to know like takedowns in Wing Chun, and at the moment I think only section 7 of the Wing Chun dummy has takedowns. In the other open hand forms, at the moment I don't think there are any, but I will have to double check. But when I do, if any new things come up, I will try to bring it up. Once again, I'm not that experienced in takedowns and I'm also still working on it. As for your other questions on Qi Gurk and exercising for Wing Chun, I'll cover that in the next episode. So until next time, keep training.